हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक समथिंग अबाउट वेल्डर परफॉर्मेंस टेस्ट। सी व्हाई वेल्डर परफॉर्मेंस टेस्ट इज नेसेसरी। वेल्डर परफॉर्मेंस टेस्ट वी कैरी आउट जस्ट टू जज द एबिलिटी ऑफ द वेल्डर वेदर ही कैन प्रोड्यूस अ साउंड वेल्डिंग और नॉट। सो इन ऑर्डर टू जज द एबिलिटी ऑफ द वेल्डर वी कैरी आउट वेल्डर परफॉर्मेंस टेस्ट। ओके, सो इन ऑर्डर टू कैरी आउट आवर वेल्डर परफॉर्मेंस टेस्ट we have various theories available for us. Normally we use ASME section 9. Okay, so in ASME section 9 we have the thickness range, we have the test positions, and everything is given there. In ASME section 9 QW452 we are having the thickness range. Okay, so what would be the thickness range, and if a person qualifies for this much thickness, then up to how much thickness he can weld. So this is given in QW452. Now let me talk about welding positions. Okay, see, we have four different welding positions for plate, and we have four different welding positions for pipe also. But today in this video I am going to restrict myself to only plate welding. Okay, so in plate welding we have four different positions. These positions are flat, horizontal, vertical, and overhead. I repeat, flat, horizontal, vertical, and overhead. Okay, see, these positions are designated by numbers and letters like 1G, 2G, 3G, 4G, and 1F, 2F, 3F, and 4F. So before moving ahead, I am going to tell you about what is G and F. G stands for group. Okay, so if it's a groove welding, then we'll call it as 1G, 2G, 3G, 4G. And F stands for fillet. If it's a fillet joint, then we'll call it as 1F, 2F, 3F, and 4F. See, if it is 1G, then our position is flat groove welding. 1 stands for flat, G stands for groove. Okay, so it's flat groove welding. Similarly, if it's 2G, then it is horizontal groove welding. 2 stands for horizontal, so 2G is horizontal groove welding. If it's 3G, then vertical groove welding. Okay, 3 stands for vertical, and if it is 4G, then it's overhead groove welding. 4 stands for overhead. Similarly, in F also we have 1F, 2F, 3F, and 4F. 1F is flat fillet welding, 2F is horizontal fillet welding, 3F is vertical fillet welding, and 4F is overhead fillet welding. Okay, so these positions are mentioned in ASME section 9 QW461.3 and QW461.5. QW461.3 we have 1G, 2G, 3G, and 4G positions, and in QW461.5 we have 1F, 2F, 3F, and 4F positions. Okay, so we have QW461.3 for 1G, 2G, 3G, and 4G, and QW461.5 for 1F, 2F, 3F, and 4F. In QW461.4, we have pipe positions, that is 1G, 2G, 5G, and 6G. In pipe, we have 1G, 2G, 5G, and 6G. Please note that in pipe, we don't have 3G and 4G. Okay? So, but I have to restrict this video to only plate welding, so we'll talk about only plate welding. So as I already said you, we have flat, vertical, horizontal, and fillet welding. Now, if our welder qualifies for flat welding, then whether he can only weld a flat welding or he can go for vertical, horizontal, or any other position. So this is given in ASME section 9. Okay, it is available in ASME 461.9. Okay, so if a welder qualifies for flat welding, then he will weld only flat weldings. Okay, he will weld only flat joints. Okay, and if a welder qualifies for horizontal position, then he can weld horizontal as well as front, as well as flat. Similarly, if a welder qualifies for vertical joint, he can weld the vertical as well as flat. Okay, and if our welder qualifies for overhead joint, then he can weld overhead joints and flat joints. Okay, so what we have to qualify our welder for all positions. In order to qualify the welder in all positions, we have to use 2G, 3G, 4G simultaneously. If our welder qualifies for 2G, 3G and 4G, then he automatically qualifies for all positions. Okay, so this is all about welder performance test. Okay, so I would request you to please like my video and subscribe my channel. Thank you.